Down is a challenging time for many, but spare a thought for those who have given birth during this period. Whānau Āwhina Plunkett says more than 600 babies a week are being born during lockdown, posing unique challenges for new parents. Katie Stevenson reports.
Heading into lockdown and straight into parenthood. Baby Kian arriving on the first day of level 4.
Our birth plan was supposed to be Panel Birthing Centre and then the hospital if we needed it. And we ended up having a home birth, so that was very different.
The change of plan because Shannon wanted to have her mum and husband as support. Many birthing centres and hospitals only allow one person during lockdown.
Sort of didn't want to feel trapped, so I just wanted the freedom of my health professionals, the support people.
Midwives are still doing home visits post-birth, but it's not without difficulties.
It takes a little bit more time to really work through that. Is everything okay? Are they doing all right? And with the loss of some of our social supports and social services, not classes, essential services, that just makes it a little bit more challenging to make sure that your family have got what they need.
Whānau Āwhina Plunkett's having to work with families virtually. The organisation takes over care of mum and baby at around 6 weeks.
We understand it's a tough time with little kids. I mean, even without COVID, right? So those intensities and pressures and those feelings of isolation and anxieties are only exacerbated. Making that connection is really important to us.
But for some, there are silver linings.
Partners are sort of staying at home, whereas usually they'd be off in 2 weeks. So we are hearing some good stories where mums are feeling a lot more supported at home.
If she needs to pass them to me, then she can. And if I need to change the nappy quick before a meeting, I can. And it just makes it a lot more practical. And it's just, I get to have cuddles as well.
Hopeful cuddles will be on the cards for more people soon. Katie Stevenson, One News.